Preparations of the SEA Games, I think we have started. We are looking at, we want to find the best team. Unfortunately, the lane patterns are not announced yet. And that is the key issue in bowling. So we are still looking at who are the best players to select. What we can confirm is that Rafiq and Jane are already in the team. The others we have not confirmed yet. So I think the preparation-wise, it's still ongoing. We have Asian Championships coming up next in end of October. We would not know when the lane patterns would be out. As far as the team announcement, we will drag as far as we can. Actually, because in 3 months, in 2-3 months, it's very hard to decide which bowlers are on form. This is a skill sport. So it depends on the mindset of the players, the confidence of the players, as well as the patterns that decides who are the best. Again, this is a 4+4. It's not a 6+6 event where we have more players to choose from. So 4+4 is going to be very, very tight. It's going to be a very, very tough competition coming to SEA Games as compared to previous editions. In the past, with 6+6, we have 6 world-class players. We have a good chance. With 4+4, all the teams are now on equal ground. Thailand, Singapore, Indonesia even, will all be on equal ground. So this is going to be one of a very, very tough SEA Games that we're going to face. As we know, the deadline is not yet finalized, so we still have some time. Not many days left, but we do have some time. This is actually with the organizing committee of Philippines. I think there's a deadline to submission for SEA Games. I think that is not yet there. The patterns are done by Kegel. It's a US company that does the patterns. Unfortunately for them, what we understood is because the decision of the lanes where they decided to have the bowling tournament to be held was decided at the very last minute. So they have to come and sanction the lanes, check the lanes to see what patterns are suited for that lanes. Unfortunately, it's only been done just recently. So we do not know when they can finalize the lane patterns. I think that's part of a parcel where the lanes were not confirmed. They wanted to be at a different bowling center. ABF decided that they cannot wait any longer. So that was the decisions that ABF has made to set the lanes at Star Mall.
To answer your question about when they're going to announce the lane pattern, normally it's about a month before the actual date. So we're still waiting. And you all may know that the lane pattern is so important, it's so crucial for bowling. It's just like the tennis in clay court and the grass. You know who is going to be better on clay, who is better on the grass. Same thing in bowling. So we got to decide until they announce the pattern, then we will see who are the bowler who better suit the type of pattern. Then we'll decide on. But mainly like our main bowlers like Rafiq and Jane is already there because they are versatile player. They can be played on grass, they can play on clay like in tennis. So they are short oils or more oils that are patterned, they are okay with it. That's why two of them are confirmed. Other than these two, the rest, everybody have a chance to come in. We have one more official tournament which is playing about the same thing. Asian Championship coming up very soon. Charlene is one, should be in one of the team to go out and try. We have tried 6 of the girls in the World Championship. We know that other countries are coming up very fast. They are improving very fast. You can say that Indonesia is coming on very near to us now. So it becomes not easy. I have to be very careful of choosing up the players. I would like to choose the best player that can be suitable for the patterns. That's why we still wait. It is not that she didn't make the World Championship. It's we trying out the other players. We know Charlene with us for so many years. I know what Charlene can do, what Charlene cannot do. So we are trying out the new players. And again, in the Asian Championship, we are trying out. We'll see where do we stand. We will meet the same team again. We will meet Singapore. We will meet up with Thailand, Indonesia again. So we can confirm that what are the teams, how good they are, in other words. Because our target to win gold is, to me, is very high. It is not easy target, but we are trying to achieve it. So we got to be very careful of selecting the players. We have one more tournament to go before we decide. We have a Thailand World Tour, which the best in the world will come, and as well as the Southeast Asia bowler will be there. So after that, then we'll decide the team going for the Asian Championship. Oh, that was the target given to us. We'll try our very best to achieve it. We always try our best to achieve the gold target. It is about 50% of the gold medal. It's not easy, but we'll try our best.
Bagi saya bangga saya dapat represent Malaysia lagi untuk SEA Games yang akan datang. Dan saya rasa pun saya deserve untuk dapatkan spot tu sebab saya rasa saya perform quite well untuk tahun ni. Dan saya harap saya dapat membantu lagi Malaysia untuk dapatkan pingat.
First of all, I'm still very happy to be able to represent Malaysia in this coming SEA Games. And as a player, I will try my very best to help our team to win. I didn't know until he announced it just now. So yeah, I think it's quite special for at this moment. But I won't get that into my head. I will have to train even harder after this.